It's been years since they told her about it. The darkness her body possessed. And the scars are still there in the mirror. Every day that she gets herself dressed. Though the pain is miles and miles behind her. And the fear is now a docile beast. If you ask her why she is still running, she'll tell you it makes her complete. I run for hope.
About Victory Day, I actually rode a train with all these amazing women from New York City. People were getting on the train coming out here.
The Victory Train is really special because I think of what it symbolizes, that we're all riding to victory, to the same destination.
All our stories are different, but we share a very unique experience that we didn't choose and was awful. It's amazing how much strength we can all find in each other.
We're all cancer survivors. I'm the mom. And unfortunately, my daughter here, Karen, who's presently undergoing chemo, and my daughter, Nancy, are also now cancer survivors. And we're going to Victory Day.
I think it's a great idea because you bring together all these people, women and men, who've gone through breast cancer, and you give them inspiration to live on, and it's helpful hearing other people's stories, what they've gone through. It's awe-inspiring. It just, it gives you chills, you know?
I had a bilateral mastectomy with chemo. I also had the bilateral mastectomy with reconstruction as well. So it was, you know, it was rough because I had young kids and they relied on me, you know, they needed mommy to be around, so I just got through it. When I was 7 months pregnant, that's when it recurred. I went to the bones and the liver. And I had spine surgery, emergency C-section, and that was a really, really tough time.
It has been so amazing riding the Victory Train. It's crazy. Everyone is so enthusiastic. I've met granddaughters, grandsons, sons, husbands, friends. It's quite emotional. Actually, I met a little girl who's been there for her mom and her aunt for, I guess, 7 years. People love this event. It's amazing how every year they want to come back.
You get off the Borchef station, they get on a bus, and then they get escorted, they come in. They listen to some inspirational speakers. Sometimes you hear from the doctors from the breast center. They let you know some of the new and up-and-coming things that are happening in breast cancer research.
I run for hope!
Breast Cancer Victory Day at Mather Hospital is an annual celebration of life, a rally for hope, and a day of reverence and unity for those whose lives have been touched by breast cancer. It is a day that honors those who claim victory over the disease. It's a day that cheers on those who are now fighting breast cancer.
Victory Day is one of the pinnacle events during the year in which we invite not only the whole Suffolk County community, but the whole regional community of Long Island all the way to New York City to come and learn more about breast cancer, learn more about detection and treatment. And it's really part of our mission to educate women, because early detection is really the best cure for breast cancer.
They let you know some of the new and up-and-coming things that are happening in breast cancer research. You have new diagnoses. I met a couple of women that are starting their chemo next week. They've already had their surgery. It's an empowering day that you're going to see all of these other survivors and see how long they are. 36 years, 29 years, I'm 9 years. And then you have people who are just coming off the chemo and radiation and they're still afraid. But you hear, you see, and you hear from all these people, and it's just inspiring and empowering.
I've come since the first Victory ride. I had bilateral breast cancer, 22 years survivor.
I went to Victory Day several years back, and Hillary Clinton was speaking, and there was another breast cancer survivor speaking, and it really, you know, tugged at my emotions. I just felt a sense of connection, and that I just realize I'm not alone.
We've all had like different types of cancer, I guess. Some more aggressive, some, you know, more able to be controlled or managed, you know, with radiation or medications.
You are responsible for every move, every word, and every action you take. So I ask you please to get on the bandwagon and go out there and speak to everyone who may not be aware of breast cancer issues. Help them to live their life to the fullest. It's your duty, it's my duty, and it's God's will.
I had a mastectomy. I had 6 months of chemo, and I went back to work, got promoted, decided to share my experiences with other women to inspire them. I ended up having a daughter in the same hospital where I had my mastectomy. And I ended up wearing lipstick to yet another C-section, having a son.
I'm doing it for, you know, other people out there that have gone through the struggle, to let them know, you know, that life can still continue. You have support, you have resources, you have friends and family to lean on, and you can get through it. You know, it makes you a stronger person, gives you a new sense of life.
Victory Day is a celebration of cancer survivors and their families. Anyone who's in support of a breast cancer patient is here today. I think we witnessed it today that you have to have hope, never give up hope, reach out to your support system, whoever is in your family that is closest to you, follow your doctor's orders. We collectively thought of what we could do to enhance programs here at the hospital for the community. I run for life.
I run for you and me, my friend. I run for life.
It's This Ball TV.